though I realize it's hard to take courage in a world full of people. You can lose sight of it all.
Every minute a woman dies in childbirth. We know that 99% of these deaths occur in the developing world. You have a 1 in 6 chance of dying in pregnancy or childbirth. That compares to, in the UK, a 1 in 8,200 chances. The scale is immense.
The project was actually a volunteer's idea, and it came about, I think, about in February. We were trying to find a way of talking about maternal mortality as an issue, but we were trying to get a sort of an engaging way of talking about maternal mortality and the fact that 1,400 women die every day in childbirth or pregnancy because they cannot access healthcare. We came with the idea of creating a blanket, a giant woolen blanket made of 1,400 knitted woolen squares, where each square represents the life of a mother who could be saved in pregnancy or childbirth if only world leaders decided to put the money where it's needed.
Prestando atenção em cores que eu não sei o nome, cores de Almodóvar, cores de Frida Kahlo, cores. Passeio pelo escuro, eu presto muita atenção no que meu irmão ouve. E com uma segunda pele, um calo, uma casca, uma cápsula protetora, eu quero chegar antes pra sinalizar o estar de cada coisa, filtrar seus graus.
We just take it for granted so often that a woman has a child and she's able to bring the child up. And what we're trying to highlight to the developed countries and also the United Nations is that this is still happening and people are still dying every single day when it should be the happiest moment of their life, really. And so we're just trying to say to them, do something about it and do something now.
But since we've discovered how many knitting groups there are in Manchester and in Greater Manchester, it's been so good and it's just been happening so quickly. And probably my favourite bit of this is actually learning to knit. It's so exciting and now I'm thinking, I might knit myself a scarf. So we'll see how that goes.
I mean, like I say, I'm a mother of two boys, but my eldest boy, when he was born, he was a month premature. And he was jaundiced when he was born, so he had to go into like a special incubator with a blue light to help him be cured of the jaundice. And he was in hospital for over a week, and then we came home and he was really sick again and he had to go back in, and he's in special care baby unit for about a week as well. And it was touch and go at one point whether or not he'd live. But as I say, at Christmas he's going to be 14. He's huge, he's about 5'8" tall, size 10 men's shoes, so little tiny premature babies with the right healthcare, like NHS here in England. I was really lucky to have such a good NHS trust in Derbyshire that we had all these facilities that he could get well and grow up to be a strapping great big lad playing rugby for school and what have you. So really good.
People have been really, really receptive, just walking past and seeing how visual the whole panel looks. And also just the fact that it's Oxfam and the fact that it's such a good project to be working on.
Next week is the UN conference to look at how we're achieving the Millennium Development Goals. And Millennium Development Goal number 5, I think it is, which is trying to combat maternal mortality. Is often, we say in Europe, because I am a member of the European Parliament, and we are also working on this issue, that we often say that it is in fact the forgotten MDG, that it is the one that doesn't seem to get attention, and it's the one that we're not achieving our objectives on. And maybe I think sometimes that's because it is about women, and women perhaps are seen to be, in some countries, less significant.
Well, most midwives are women. I mean, it is complex in itself. I mean, the UK is having problems around that as well. But I think it's a complex situation. Part of the reason is that we are not actually valued. We're not well paid, we're not valued. Most of us do it because we love it. It's such fabulous work. And I think part of that reason is that we're women. And women, I don't think women are very valued at all, really.
Clear that the MDG on maternal mortality has got seriously off track. There are others where we're making progress. And when we sat down to look at it as EU member states, there was a recognition that not enough was being done. Now, I think Jilly said very clearly that we always made the commitment to it, but it's not up to one member state alone to do that.
Most French aid goes to HIV. Obviously, we campaign for HIV as well, but that's most of the aid. And most of the HIV aid goes to the Global Fund. Again, we're great supporters of the Global Fund. And despite all that, they cut all aid. So not only HIV is suffering, but also this marginalized MDG is like maternal health is suffering. Italy is cutting its aid. The Japanese, at least they didn't increase it if they didn't cut it. And these are Germany is going, okay, but I don't think maternal health is particularly on the top of the agenda. You know, your government has to really make the influencing others a huge priority, but also for us in the NGO community to link with our colleagues in other countries.
The other truth on maternal mortality is it's not actually going to even be enough to strengthen healthcare systems so we've got the best family planning available and, you know, as many skilled birth attendants. If women haven't got a voice to demand what is theirs and it's okay that they can receive it, we're never going to make the progress we really need.
That's me. Brilliant.
I think I tell him how impressive it is that so many people really, really cared about it. I think it was really lovely today just seeing just people coming past, and when they heard about it, they wanted to get involved with it. So I think I'd want to tell him how many women, I think especially, really feel it's important that women across the world have the same rights as they do.
It's not fair that just privileged countries like Europe, Great Britain and America are allowed to have this, and then people in disadvantaged countries or haven't got quite so much money, it's not fair.
This is really important. Please listen, do something about it. You signed the agreement about the Millennium Development Goals, and you know, you have a duty to kind of do something about this, so get off your arse and do it.
Come on, Gordon, be a leader, be a real leader of men and women, and get every world leader do is big to make sure that every mother across the world can access a doctor, a nurse and a midwife whilst in pregnancy and childbirth.